The spinal nodes, they are neat. All spinal nodes, each spinal node is neat. It includes sensory portion, motor portion, and together with motor portion to the all tissues comes vegetative portion for the control of the trophic. No, for some other functions about which we will speak later, but for the control of the trophic. If each spinal nerve is mixed, it includes the sensory nucleus to which information comes in, it is sensitive to the posterior horn. It includes the motor nucleus in the anterior horn from which exits motor portion. And only from thoracolumbar region, which where is placed vegetative center, in the eighth solical, in the all thoracic, and in the two lumbar segmentus, is placed vegetative center for the control of the trophic. From this vegetative center, the vegetative portion will go by its concrete nerve to the objects, or will go by spinal cord above or below, and will complete into the another nerves, which begin from segmentus which don't include vegetative center. The nerve, each nerve includes, well, for example, my dear, here you can see, for example, eighth solical segment. Here you can see, will be sensory portion, you can see here will be motor portion, and here will be vegetative portion. This will be spinal nerve. But all thoracic segmentus, they will produce nerves which will have the same characteristic. For example, if will be the number seven cervical segment, number six, look here, you can see vegetative portion will go up and will exit. Did you understand? If here we don't have the lateral horns, vegetative portion by white matter will go up and will complete into the nerves. Do you see? Because each spinal nerve is mixed. If you remember, the spinal nerves, they begin from compact butterfly shape. When the spinal cord enters into the cranial cavity by its continuation, which is called medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata includes new nuclei. And new nuclei, which are subcortical centers. For example, olive nucleus, gracilis nucleus, cunatus nucleus. Do you see? New. They do the any function. These are subcortical centers. And these new nuclei, they will cut compact butterfly shape. And the gray matter from which began the spinal nerves, it will be placed by any focal positions. If any place will be sensory nuclei, the nerve which brings information to them will be only sensory. If anywhere will be only motor nuclei, the nerve which begins from motor nuclei will exit, it will be only motor. If any will be sensory and motor, the nerve will be mixed sensory and motor. If anywhere in the collection will be sensory, motor, and vegetative, the nerve will include all these functional portions. Did you understand? Because the cranial nerves, they have different functional portions. This is one information. Another information. If you remember, sensory portion of each spinal nerve has location of its body, the body of the afferent neuron in the spinal ganglion. If the cranial nerves will include sensory portion, again, without brain, near the brain, will locate the some ganglions, which will have individual names, and in these ganglions will locate the bodies of the afferent neurons, which completed into the nerve. Did you understand? You can see the all nerves, they have their concrete individual number, and they have their concrete name. For example, if the north number one, this will be smelling or olfactoric north. If you will say me north number one, I will understand this is only olfactoric, smelling north. If you will inform me north number five, I know this is only north trigeminal. Did you understand? Because if you will inform me by number, if you will inform me by name, I will understand about you, about what you speak. Did you understand? We have 31 pairs of the spinal nerves, and each from them is mixed. And we have 12 pairs of the cranial nerves. These cranial nerves, they have individual functional characteristics. Some of them sensory, some of them motor, some of them mixed, but they include the different functional portions. Can be sensory, motor, and vegetative, can be sensory and motor, can be motor and vegetative. Did you understand? Because nerves will be different. I said you, the afferent or sensory nerves or sensory portions of the spinal nerves, they have location of their bodies in the ganglions. For the spinal nerves, this will be concretely spinal ganglions. For the another nerves, they will have another names. Will be, for example, trigeminal ganglion, which will include the sensory portion, will be cochlear or spiral ganglion. By last time explained you, it is placed inside in the spiral membrane. Do you remember? Vestibular ganglion, which has bodies in the internal acoustic meatus. And do you see another will have the sum any ganglions which have individual names. Except first and second pairs of the cranial nerves. The nerve number one and the nerve number two, they don't have ganglions. Also, the nerve number one, smelling or olfactoric nerve, the nerve number two, optic nerve, they don't have nuclei to which they will bring information. No, like afferent, do you see, portion brings information to the posterior horn. They don't have nuclei, do you see, for especially these nerves. They have only subcortical centers to which they will bring information, and this nuclei will do any correct function for the visit of the smelling or optic information, do you see, vision information. For example, do you know start vision reflex? Do you remember start smelling reflex or another functions about which we will speak today? Do you understand? You can see these two nerves, they don't have the nuclei for the concrete nerve, no, for the origination or for the visit of this nerve, and they don't have ganglions. Why? If you remember, by last time, I said you, what is eye? The eye, this is exit from brain of the piece of the nerve tissue. Do you remember I explained you about bladders? Yes? And here exit from brain many nuclei. And they complete into the different layers of the retina. Did you understand? The smelling or olfactoric nerve, again, like optic nerve, we had exit of the some cells, which will locate by local position, and around of them, like around of the eye, will be formed cartilage plates, which will complete into the walls of the nose. Did you understand? Because these two nerves, they include, do you see, in the peripheral region, the cells. And because they don't have concrete cells from which they will originate or to which they will come. They will come concretely to the concrete centers which will do any function. This is general information. My dear, now I will draw you the scheme of the smelling vein. For the first pair and for the second pair is correctly to inform, this is smelling way, this is optic, optic way, because the nodes are placed only by smaller portion and not everywhere. I will draw, and you will copy, the big scheme, which I will continue from left, do you see, angle, to right angle, and from lower to upper. You can see this will be nasal cavity, inferior, medial, and superior nasal nerves. You can see here will be cribriform plate. Cribriform plate. Do you remember two more sides from crista galli? Do you see on the ethmoid bone? We have plate with many openings. Do you see? Here, do you see, will be callosum body. Callosum body. You can see here will be cingulum gyrus, which continues by bridge to the medial side, do you see, of the temporal lobe, by parahippocam gyrus. Parahippocam gyrus will end by hook. Do you understand about which I speak? You can see here will be thalamus. Here will be thalamus. Here will be medullar stria of the thalamus. Here will be habenul. Here will be habenular triangle. Interesting. You can see here will be hypothalamus, optic chiasm, tuber cinereum, mammillary body. Mammillary body. Listen to me, what is mammillary body? Mammillary body, this is tip of the column. Do you see? Here you can see the tip of the column, and its concrete body passes inside through the hypothalamus, exits, does arc, and do you see, comes, do you see, into the parahippocam gyrus. This is called fornix. Fornix. And fornix begins by mammillary body. If you remember, between callosum body and fornix is placed plate. Septum pellucidum, transparent septum. Did you understand? Here you can see will be subcallosal field. Subcallosal field, it is called area subcallosa. On the frontal lobe, on the basal side, is placed bulb of the smelling way, olfactoric bulb, which continues, you can see, by olfactoric tract. Olfactoric tract expands by what? Olfactoric triangle, do you remember? And here will be anterior perforant substance. In the superior nasal meatus, do you remember when we studied nasal cavity, we decided the nasal cavity divides into two symmetric parts, and each symmetric part subdivides into the nasal meatuses, inferior, medial, and superior. Inferior and medial nasal meatuses, they are for the visit of the air by inspiration and exit by expiration, because it's called respiratory region. The superior nasal meatus, it is smaller, it is placed very deeply, very upper, distally from enters into the nose. Why? Because they include the smelling receptors. Why is placed very deeply, very upper, only in this superior nasal meatus? Because sometimes if we will smell the aggressive things, you see, we will do reflex and our receptors will not be destroyed by contact with this abnormal aggressive air. Did you understand? Because here we have smelling receptors in the superior nasal meatus. Smelling receptors. Listen to me. This is smelling region, and some minutes ago I said you, from brain, like for the production of, for the development of the eye, for the development of the smelling region, we have exit of the nose. Because here Receptors will come to their bodies, which will be bipolar cells. Here will come from receptors dendrites, do you see? And from those bodies will exit the axons. Here we have many millions of the receptors and many millions of the bipolar cells. Do you understand? And you can see axons from bipolar cells will collect by 10, 12, 15, 20. And they will collect, do you see, into the thicker thread. Axons will collect into the thicker thread. Each thread will be many, do you see, axons. Do you see? These are called olfactoric fibers. Fibers or thicker threads. The thicker thread, do you see, is do you see, collection of the some axons. Now, if I will take any thread, do you see, and I can separate the some threads, if they are thicker, into the smaller portions, do you see, thinner portions. You can see, this will be olfactoric fillers, filia olfactoria. Filia olfactoria will perforate, you can see, the will pass through the cribriform plate into the cranial cavity. And these axons, which complete by 10 or 20 into the filia olfactoria, they will come to this, do you see, olfactoric valve. If this is thicker portion, we can understand this is collection of the bodies of the nerve cells, like ganglions, but it's not called ganglion, do you see? And here, axons of these bodies, which will be bodies of the first neuron of the smelling way, they will come, do you see, to the olfactoric bulb, and by synapses will give information to the bodies of the second neurons. These are bodies of the second neurons. I am first neuron, I give information for him, he is second neuron. Do you see? Axons of the second neurons, they complete into the olfactoric tract. Tractus olfactoricus. Olfactoric tract, it subdivides into three portions. One portion will enter into the gray matter of the subcallosal area. And by synapse will give the information to this gray matter. Axons of this gray matter will go inside into the cingulum gyrus. Do you remember we studied with you association fibers? And I said you longitudinal, superior, longitudinal, inferior, insenat, cingulum. Do you remember? Cingulum is belt. You can see here if we will take out the cortex inside, we will see belt or the portion which is formed by many axons. And you can see, and it brings, do you see, there information for the concrete analysis into the uncus. This, do you see, information will come into the uncus by white matter, do you see, by white matter of the cingulum gyrus, do you see, and will pass through the cingulum gyrus, through the parahippocampal gyrus, and to the uncus. This is the first. This is your way for the visit of the smelling into the uncus for the concrete analysis. And listen to me, if we will separate two hemispheres, we see here will be cingulum gyrus, do you see? And it is placed medially than all another ways. And it's called medial stria, medial way, medial stria, stria medialis, or medial line. But when we started with you, the brain, I informed you, we have many cortical, many subcortical centers and some cortical centers. For what? Because smelling was important for the animals which passed through the long phylogenesis. If it was important, do you see, for the all stages of the phylogenesis, we store these centers in our brain. Do you see? And you can see, this is one way. If this way will be destroyed, we will not get, we will not do analysis of the smell. Yes? No, for us is so-so. And for the animals, this is very important. Cannot find the food, cannot decide the some and other problems of their life without smell. Because our God gave the three directions of the smelling into the cortex. If the one from way will be destroyed, another ways will bring the same information for the analysis into the cortex. You can see another portion of the optic tract, it enters inside into the olfactory triangle, which places gray matter also. From gray matter of the olfactory triangle, the same information which passed by last direction will go into the septum pellucidum, into the fornix, by fornix into the parahippocampal gyrus, and into the uncus for the analysis. The same information came only by another way. Didn't it? But listen to it. Do you see the fornix? It from middle goes so to lateral. Yes? And it will called intermedial way. Intermedial way. Stria intermedialis. Intermedial because why? One is medially, next, which I will explain, you will be laterally, and this is placed between them. Intermedial stria. Do you see? If this way will be destroyed, this way will bring the same information for the analysis. Listen to me. If you remember, here, do you see, here will be lateral groove. And inside in the lateral groove is placed what?
Insula.
А кто это брал? Это Степан?
Здравствуйте.
Так, my dear, look please here. My dear, do you see? Here do you see? Is uncus? Do you see? Here is uncus. Do you see? And here do you see lateral groove? Inside do you see is insula? Do you remember? Mm-hmm. And here is anterior perforant substance. From anterior perforant substance will go impulse into the insula, and from it will enter into the uncus. For on this picture, you can see this is third portion of the smelling tract will come into the anterior perforant substance, where is gray matter, and from here will go through the insula laterally into the uncus. Do you see? You can see. From here, do you see, through the insula into the uncus. It will called lateral stria. Do you understand? This is another way. You can see smelling tract, it, olfactory tract, it divided into three portions. And these three portions come into the primary subcortical centers. Subcallosal field, subcallosal area, olfactoric triangle, and the anterior perforant substance. These are positions of the primary subcortical centers. For what are them? For the separation of this, do you see, common information and bringing it to the cortex, into the uncus, by different directions. Did you understand? If the one from this way will be destroyed, the uncus every time for the differentiation, for the checking, will get, do you see, information. You can see, besides...
Can you say that the exit of this nerve will be the cribriform plate?
Through the cribriform plate of the skull. Do you remember? Two orbital parts, and here will be plate of the ethmoid bone, and here the crista gyri. And on this plate opens from the nasal cavity directly, do you see, will go into the anterior cranial fossa to the olfactoric bulb. Did you understand? My dear, I draw you three directions of the smelling from smelling region, olfactoric region of the nasal cavity, into the concrete analysis which uncus does. Did you understand? But if you remember, we have the some subcortical smelling centers. You can see from olfactoric triangle, the impulse will enter into the anterior tubercle of the thalamus. Into the anterior tubercle of the thalamus. Do you see? From, from olfactoric triangle. For what? Do you remember I said you came on our department for my abnormal emotion? Did you understand? Listen to me. If you remember this, I draw your ulcer. From the anterior tubercle will be formed by axons medullar stria, and medullar stria joins to the thalamus. This is line, do you remember? And it comes, do you see, into the tertiary center. This is gray matter, which is placed in the habenular triangle. Look, let's get from habenular triangle will be descending smelling way to the anterior horns of the spinal cord, and after that to the muscles. Look, please, here. Look at me. You can see emotions abnormal, and do you see reflex? Did you understand? Emotions here, and do you see very fast together with emotions will be smelling reflex. Did you understand? For example, is this ammonia or something aggressive? Yeah. You can see another. If you remember, do you see inside in the temporal lobe? Inside in the temporal lobe is placed amygdaloid nucleus. Amygdaloid nucleus. Do you remember? Listen to me. For visit to the amygdaloid nucleus, which besides control of internal of the functions of the internal organs, it is also smelling subcortical center. And for the visit of the information is easy to visit from what? From, do you see, anterior perforant substance. It enters, do you see, through the insula, and here, do you see, will enter information into the amygdaloid nucleus. For what? Do you remember I explained you? Amygdaloid nucleus controls internal organs, stomach, intestine, heart, do you see, all things. And do you remember I explained you, uterus is internal organ. Do you remember I informed you about abnormal smelling of the women through the pregnancy? Because every time this nucleus gets information, and also it controls internal organs. If it controls internal organs, it takes the information about condition of the internal organs. By pregnancy, new information came to the amygdaloid nucleus. It didn't adapt it by last 20 years, and it has confused. If it has confused, do you see new information about condition of the organs came to it from uterus, for example? Do you see it is also smelling, do you see, center subcortical? It answer by abnormal smelling reaction. Do you remember, the some women cannot cook the meat. The some women like to color the, smell the color for the nails. I informed you, the more of women, I don't know why, like to smell petrol. Did you understand? This is confused. Did you understand? You can see another information. If you remember, I said you came on our department and have some abnormal emotions. And listen to me. From uncus, we have opposite way. Do you see? Here, Uncus did analysis, and do you see? And opposite way, through the parahypocam gyrus, through the fornix, comes into the mammillary body. Opposite way, after analysis, do you see? And listen to me, from mammillary body, do you see? The way will come into the anterior tubercle of the thalamus. And it can correct our emotions, can increase, can decrease. Did you understand? Because after checking, after differentiation of this hearing, the cortex, do you see, can control the emotions which thalamus produced by visit of the smelling. Did you understand? You can see. This is nerve number one, which is called olfactoric nerve or smelling nerve. It doesn't have ganglions. It doesn't have nuclei. It has only subcortical and cortical centers. The receptors of this smelling or olfactoric nerve, it is correctly to give it name way, they are placed in the superior nasal meatus. Here in the superior nasal meatus are placed bodies of the first neurons of this way. The axons of these bodies will complete into the olfactoric filus by 10, 12, 20, and will produce the tica cord, and these are called olfactoric filus. They pass through the openings of the cribriform plate, and they visit to the olfactoric bulb, which is formed by bodies of the second neurons, and the first neurons by synapses give information to the second neurons. Axons of the second neurons, they collect into the olfactoric tract at first, and the olfactoric tract divides into three portions, which is specially for the bringing information to the cortex by different directions. And because olfactoric tract divides into three portions, which will come into three primary subcortical centers. Into the gray matter of the subcallosal area, into the gray matter of the olfactoric triangle, and into the gray matter of the anterior perforant substance. From subcallosal area, the medial stria will pass through the cingulum gyrus parahypocam gyrus into the uncus. From olfactoric triangle, do you see the axons through the septum pellucidum fornix parahypocam gyrus will come into the uncus. This is intermedial stria. From anterior perforant substance, very fast to the side, will direct lateral stria and will come through the insula into the uncus. And uncus does analysis of the information which it got by three directions. And from uncus we have opposite way, which do you see will start from uncus through the parahypocam gyrus, through the fornix, will come into the mammillary body, and from mammillary body will come to the control of the emotions of the thalamus. Do you see? To the thalamus, before this, we got, do you see, the information from primary centers for the production of these emotions. From cortex, we have correction of these emotions, do you see? And also from primary centers into the mammillary body will come another information, no, for the according of the smelling and condition of the our internal organs. I said you can be pregnancy, do you see, can be the cancer of the stomach. Very often, do you see, the persons have problem with smelling because amygdaloid nucleus will get the new information from organs with problem, and also it has smelling function because you can see can be problem with smelling, like confuse of the amygdaloid nucleus, which got new information about condition of the organs. Did you understand? This is olfactoric nerve, first tier of the cranial nerves. Nerve number two. Again, this is like olfactoric nerve is only sensory nerve which doesn't have the sensory ganglion and the nuclei. It has only cortical and subcortical centers. You can see this is right, my eye. I stand in front of you. Do you see? This is my right eye. Do you see? Here is my left eye. Да, вот там вот наверху, все наверху, наружное, внутреннее, а
А у вас только, а не, ухо правильно, все, что-то я топлю.
Look right here. You can see this is right eye. This, do you see, is iris. This is pupil. Do you see, this is, do you see, opposite left eye. This is pupil. You can see your name, Ikaro. And your name,
Vishnu.
You can see, my dear. I will take for example only my right eye. Do you see? Look with here how they see. Don't change your position. This is my right eye. Ikaro sits, do you see, laterally. And do you see, he has projection through the pupil to the medial retina. Do you see? He sits laterally, but the rays from it will go to the medial retina. Do you see? Vishnu, he sits medially than it. Do you see? And do you see, he has projection to the lateral. You can see, this is Ikaro, do you see? This is Vishnu, do you see? You can see Ikaro, do you see? I see by right eye, but by, do you see, medial part of the retina. Vishnu, I see by right eye, but by lateral part of the retina. If you remember, retina includes three layers. Do you see, this information came, and do you see, to the first layer, rods and cones. Do you see? They will transform this light, do you see, this information into the nerve impulse. Do you understand? You can see, this will be bodies of the first neurons, which are unipolar cells. They are receptors, and they are unipolar cells by the same time. You can see. Axons of the first neurons contact with second layer, which is formed by bipolar cells. Do you see, this will be bodies of the second neuron of the vision wave. Do you see, this, do you see, unipolar cells, they give, do you see, to the second layer information, which is formed by bipolar cells. Axons of the bipolar cells, axons. Do you see contact with bodies of the multipolar cells, which complete into the third layer? You can see first neurons gives information second neurons give information third neurons. Axons of the third neurons will call this. Do you see is lateral side? This is medial side of the retina. Axons of the third layer will complete to the posterior polar. From lateral retina and from medial retina. Do you see? Listen to me. This will be optic nerve, which passes through the optic canal from orbit into the cranial cavity. Do you see? Here will be, do you see, another nerve, which, do you see, comes from left eye, and it has the same mechanism, do you see, into the cranial cavity. Listen to me. Ikaro sits, do you see, laterally for my right eye. He has projection to the medial retina, from lateral side to the medial retina of the right eye. I will differentiate him by left hemisphere. Do you see? Vishnu sits, do you see, medially, do you see, has projection to the lateral retina of the right eye. I will differentiate him by right hemisphere. From my eye, do you see, information about lateral objects goes to opposite, do you see, hemisphere. Information about medial object goes to same hemisphere. On this side will be again medial portion will cross to the opposite side. Lateral portion, do you see, from medial object will come to it. Did you see?
Mm-hmm.
This is optic nerve. Only this crossing of the medial parts is optic chiasm. And this is optic tract. Optic tract consists information from two eyes. My dear, do you remember when we studied the skull? We studied chiasmatic groove. This, do you see, portion joins to the chiasm. You can see from here, do you see exact medial portion direct to opposite side. From here, from this optic canal to opposite side. Behind of the chiasmatic groove to which joins optic chiasm is placed turcic saddle. Do you remember of the skull? Turcic saddle. In the center of the turcic saddle is hypophyseal fossa. Fossa for the location of the pituitary gland. I want to take the skull. My dear, groove, depression, and here do you see, will locate pituitary gland. If will be cancer or tumor of pituitary gland, it can press or it can destroy what? Optic chiasm. My dear, optic chiasm, this is information about lateral objects. Did you understand? Which will go to the opposite hemispheres. If here will be destruction of the optic chiasm on the ophthalmologic clinic, you will contact with this. Listen to me. I see, I have vision only in front of. Now I sit, I have normal my nerves, do you see? Normal chiasm. I see you, and by my lateral vision, I see the dot. Did you understand? Listen to me. If I will have destruction of the optic chiasm, I will see only in front of me. I will see Vishnu for, do you see, vision of the Ikaru. I want to rotate for him the head. Did you understand? We will lose lateral vision squares. Did you understand why? Okay. You can see. Here will be optic tract. Optic tract will divide into three portions. Do you remember smelling tract? Do you see? It divides into three parts. On this side will be the same, into the three parts. One part will go into the superior calliculuses of the tectal lamin, into the superior calliculuses of the tectal lamin. Do you remember? This is, do you see, interpeduncular fossa, and these are superior calliculuses. Did you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Will come here from this side, and from this side will come here. For what? Do you remember? Vision start reflex. Because from here will go tecta spinal way for the production of the vision start reflex. Did you understand? But for today, you know only this function. Listen to me. If you remember, this is cerebral aqueduct. Here is motor nucleus of the ocular motor nerve number 3. And here, do you see, is accessory nucleus of the ocular motor nerve. Vegetative nucleus for the sphincter pupil muscle. Listen to me. From superior calliculus, this information you didn't know, do you see, will be contact with accessory nucleus of the ocular motor nerve. Ocular motor nerve, do you see, which we will study later, exits by interpeduncular fossa, will come into the orbit by superior orbital fissure, and it will bring, do you see, vegetative portion. Vegetative nerves, they don't go alone in our organism. They take any transport and by it will travel to their objects. For this moment will be transport, somatic, ocular, motor nerve. Vegetative nerve will take it like bus, do you see? And will come into the orbit by superior orbital fissure. My dear, but what I want to inform you, I will push her by needle. She will do reflex. Here is somatic nerve system, brought information to the spinal cord, and from spinal cord, the motor, do you see, order to the muscles. Impulse by somatic nerves goes with very fast velocity. For example, do you see, from my pushing to the center and from this, impulse goes with velocity near 120 meters in 1 second. Do you understand? Listen to me. Vegetative impulse comes to the organs or to the objects with very lesser velocity. Why? By last time I said you, vegetative nerve system, it controls vital functions or smooth muscular tissue, secretion tissue by which do you see internal organs are formed. Do you see? Now try to understand. Small and large intestine. They include in their walls the smooth muscular tissue. Yes? Smooth muscular tissue. And try to think. If the impulse from center will come to the smooth muscular tissue, like for the skeletal muscles, and they will contract with velocity 120 meters in 1 second, look here, we will have